how do we prepare for the process of a general management company? If I'm really interested in general management domain, what should I do for the next 1-2 months before the summer placement actually arrives? Your opinion should be very strongly backed up by facts, figures or examples. If you're able to analyze the problem and maybe not go to the solution, 90% of your GD is sorted. Before starting with general management, I'll give a brief background about myself. I did my MBA from Faculty of Management Studies, Delhi in 2023. Before that, I did BTech in Chemical Engineering from NIT Bhopal. I did my summer internship with TAS, was offered a PPO and joined TAS as the full-time role. When we talk of general management, let's talk of the companies that comes to the campus to offer the B-School students the general management role. First is Tata Group's Leadership General Management Program, TAS. Then we have Aditya Birla Group's Leadership Program, Mahindra's General Management Program. Other companies also like Reliance Industries, RPG, Capgemini Elite, they also offer general management roles. Now what happens when we delve into details of the first year of these companies and you join them as a full-time employee? The first year is rotation of stints across different companies, different domains, different projects that come across. For example, when you take Tata Group's Leadership Program, TAS, there you will be rotated across different companies with a 3-month stint, 3 business stints and 1 community stint. Community stint is one thing that is common with Mahindra's Leadership Program as well, Aditya Birla as well. When we look at it from managerial perspective, basically you will be working in different domains. You can be working in the strategy, at a strategy role in Croma, you can be working in marketing role in Air India or product planning in Tata Motors or anything. You will be learning different domains with getting experiences of multiple companies. When we move to different companies that offer a general management role like Aditya Birla or Capgemini Elite, the students do not move across companies, but instead different projects, different teams. Again, the domain changes here. You will get a gist of different managerial domains, and hence it's called a general management program. Now coming to the part where how would a student analyze if my profile is fit for a general management company? How should my CV look like? Answering to this, all the general management companies, they do not have a minimum qualification unlike other domains. For example, consulting have the 999 qualification, or product management looks for candidates in work experience. General management, on the other hand, looks for a balanced profile. A student with good academics, with good work experience or internships, some good position of responsibilities, extracurriculars. So basically, when we look at a CV, which can be an ideal candidate for a general management role, the CV would be balanced. It will not be skewed. Basically, all of the columns, whether that's internship, PORs, projects, extracurriculars, would be balanced and would look uniformly distributed CV. So when you're making a CV specifically for these companies, you can also highlight these points. Not only the body of your CV, but even the spikes can not only be your achievements from academics, but also something that sets you apart, whether that's your POR or an extracurricular activity. A balanced CV is something that is looked forward by general management companies. Now, coming to the processes of how these companies follow up with the summer internship process or the final placement roles, they have a generalized structure. First, they will have an application-based form where you will have to fill subjective answers. It could be questions like, where do you see yourself in 5 years, or what are your strengths, what are your weaknesses. You have to fill in those answers along with your other academic and profile-based details. Second step could be a psychometric test. It could be in the form of a questionnaire, in the form of a website that they'll have to that they'll provide a link to follow, or in a form of a gamification round where you'll have to perform certain games on your mobile phone or devices, and basis the CV-based shortlisting and the psychometric test, you're given the shortlist for the next round, which is group discussion. When we talk of GDs, the GDs that are for the general management role are very different from other GDs. They are more interactive in nature. They are more based on finding problems and then analyzing those problems to find up a solution to take everybody together, unlike the other marketing GDs that student would be preparing for. When we look company-based, company-specific processes, TAS conducts a very different format of GD, which is Chairman GD. Chairman GD is basically where, if there are 9 students in the panel, there will be 9 different case scenarios given to the entire panel, where one student will act like the chairman of the group. It could be a CXO level case scenario, and then with the entire group, with the entire panel, they'll have to come up with a solution. The cases could be ethically based. For example, you are the marketing head of a company, say XYZ, and there has been a campaign that is released recently, and there is an outlash from the customers. And how are you going to handle this situation? Would you take that advertisement down, which you felt was right, but now is not very much accepted by the public? How are you going to go about it? These are the examples of cases that could be given. Now, if you are the chairman, in that case, you will take everybody together, take their opinion, and then finally come up to a solution. And one by one, different scenarios are given to each of the person until the entire panel is completed. That's the format of Chairman GD. Similarly, other companies also perform group discussions in order to select the candidates for personal interviews. How can you prepare for it? How do you look forward to it? That we can discuss in the next section. The third part, once you clear the group discussion, you go to the personal interview round. Here, again, one thing which is common for all general management companies is the interviews are a little long and they are very interactive in nature. They'll focus more on the behavioral aspect of the student, on what the person is like, do you know about yourself? What are your clear statement of purposes? Why do you want to join this role? Are you clear with your mind, or is just that you're just joining here? Now, when we look at it, how do we prepare for the process of a general management company? If I'm really interested in general management domain, what should I do for the next 1-2 months before the summer placement actually arrives? First part is be very thorough with your HR or behavioral answers. Do not structure your answers and muck them up. It should be very humanized, very natural. But when I say that you should be very thorough with yourself, it's basically introspecting. When they ask you a question of the biggest challenge that you faced in your entire life, you should not think a lot, maybe a few seconds, but the incident should be on top of your head. The answer should be well structured. It cannot be very long. Being verbose is a very big no-no for an interview when you look at from a general management perspective. It should be properly structured, properly delivered. Second part is doing your proper research about the companies. If TAS is coming to your campus and you're really interested to be there as the summer intern, you have to be very thorough of all the companies, the businesses that Tata Group is running for. There should not be a case where you're in an interview and you're having a discussion on Starbucks, and then you get to know, oh, Starbucks is Tata Alliance. I did not know that. Again, that showcases your less interest in the company, and you can simply be rejected. Third, being very clear with your objective. Why do you want to join that company? Why do you want to join that role? Your answer should be it should not be very generic in nature. It should be a little personalized and very clear and structured. And if you're not able to justify your interest in that company, you may not be an apt candidate for them. Apart from that, opinion-based questions are also asked in the interview. On general knowledge, on current affairs, they can ask you questions on maybe elections, on any current affairs, that international current affairs or national, your opinion on it. How do you find the decision to be? Are you in favor of or are you against, and why? Your opinion should be very strongly backed up by facts, figures, or examples. It should not be a very simple statement, okay, I really agree with what the results of election was. This is the preparation for the interview bit. When we take a step back and talk of the GD, the group discussion, so you'll be preparing and you'll be giving a lot of GDs among your peers. But one thing that you have to make sure in mind when you are in a general management group discussion and not in any other company's GD, is you have to be humble first. It will not be an aggressive GD. when you're in a sales and marketing GD, you're proving that you have good negotiation and convincing skills. Hence, it can turn out to be a little aggressive. But when you're in a GenMan company, you have to prove that you're a good leader. You can take everybody together. If there is a candidate in the panel who's trying to speak and is not able to, you can maybe say that, let him complete. If you are somebody who's trying to make an entry and somewhere you're not able to, you cannot show that on your face. You can very politely say, please let me complete. If you want to make up a point, make sure that your entry in a GD is not more than 1 minute or 90 seconds for that mark. It should be small and concise and to the point. You should not repeat your points. And when the cases are given, try to include all the perspectives. This is going to help you a lot in TAS GD specifically. So taking everybody's perspective. If a case is given, you should include business perspective, ethical perspective, customer's point of view, maybe a legal or environmental point of view, if that is the case, if that is the element there. Try to think of more point of views or the areas where you can bring in a solution for. If you're able to analyze the problem and maybe not go to the solution, 90% of your GD is sorted. The solution is only 10 to 20%. Analyzing and reaching to that solution is something that you remember. That's about the GD preparation. Giving as many mock GDs as you can. Again, try to speak to mentors, alumni. People have already joined and given that group discussion because they have the first-hand experience. And practice mock GDs, mock interviews so that you're first-hand prepared. A step back again, talking of the application form and the gamification round. So psychometric test, there is nothing much that you can prepare for psychometric test, whether that's a GenMan company or any other. It's just basis your personality to see if you're culturally or fit for the company. Nothing that you can prepare much. It's just you have to be honest. It's just one-to-one answers that you have to give as yes or no, rating from 1 to 5, or games that you have to solve, analyzing your puzzle solving skills or focus or other things. The application round, on the other way, whenever a company gives an application round, application to be filled for, think your answers through. Do not fill the answers in one go. Maybe form an answer in an offline format, get it verified from other people. Think that the answer is not very generic. Not everybody wants the same thing in 5 years. You may want something else that should be reflected in your answer, and only then fill up your form. Again, this form can be a basis during your interview as well. Steward, don't want to risk that up. Thank you so much.